people that are in trouble, concern taps that in your brain. So when people say, I'm worried about Owen Benjamin, he should call me. We'll get him back in the fold. You know, he's off the grid. That taps into people's desire to help their community and manipulates them. Does it look like I need advice from Sam Tripoli? He's a sodomite, lonely, evil, silly little man. I'm a legend. It's like that's the wicked wizardry of empathy. But compassion is about understanding your fellow man. You know, where it's like, I remember Fahad and Abdul. There were Saudi Arabians with 30 plus camels. They didn't even pray much. They loved America and they're very gracious to my mother. So I can hate Islam. I can want Saudi Arabia to get the fuck out of our affairs. But I always remember those guys. And that's why Jesus said, you know, hate the sin, love the sinner. I'm not good with the turn the other cheek shit, but hate the sin, love the sinner is profound. Because you don't win if you hate the sinner and you love the sin. Look at Hitler. Hitler lost dramatically. Because it wasn't about taking, do you think that a Rothschild wore a yellow star? Do you think anyone that was responsible for the World War I disaster ever wore a star? No. It was the people just being fucked with. And I'll tell you something else. This whole Holocaust, not Hitler's and Hitler's the worst man who ever lived. I can name 100 Hitlers in 10 minutes. Those are a type of person. Khal Drogo was Hitler. And women found that attractive. What the fuck was my point? Hitler. What was I talking about? You guys are talking about my mustache. That's hysterical. Jesus did not say that. That demon-possessed Gandhi did. I don't know. Whatever. What the? Turn the other cheek? No. Love the... Hate the sin, love the sinner is absolutely in the Bible, right? There's no way I dreamt that. What the fuck was I just talking about? Hitler now lives on the moon? Ah, it's hilarious. Oh. How ineffective it is. So Hitler hated the sinner and avoided the sin. Did he take down the banks? Did he take down the alliances that unfairly wouldn't let Germany trade after World War I or defend themselves? No. Killed 60 million fucking people. There's dramatic repercussions for this shit. I'm not saying this to be accepted by fucking BuzzFeed. I'm off grid. It's like I'm not looking for any social points. I just gave Hitler a slight defense. That doesn't work. That creates an archetype that people can use. And now the Holocaust narrative, who does it hurt? Jews. There's a reason that so many Jews are leftists who fucking hate themselves. There's a problem in Israel with it. There's something about survivor's guilt where relatives of Holocaust victims and children turn out to be these self-hating atheists who are leftists because the human psyche isn't made for this much trauma. To go into Israeli schools or all these like Jewish movies where it's like they turned them into lampshades and Anne Frank just wanted her grueling to get out of the attic. And you're feeling so much for these people that you start being like, why the fuck am I still alive? What's wrong with me? How do I enjoy this shit? You know? And it fucks up your head. There's so many self-hating Jews. So what do? Self-hating people are the most dangerous people on the planet. The self-hating. They're self-hating black people. Usually they just kill each other in the inner cities and shit. You know, when they got no dads, their mom just beats the fuck out of them. You know, media keeps telling them they're rappers and gangsters and shit. It's all CIA shit. So they hate themselves. So they just kill people. Very dangerous, dude. The snake that hates himself, the hollow snake, is the real enemy snake. Like, the other tribe that isn't in your interest but has self-respect. I've had Muslims write to me, and I've taken shots at Islam, guys. Like, piss be upon him, and I go hard. I've had devout Muslims write to me being like, it pisses me off so much how you talk about Muhammad, but I love your family. I love your morals. I like you. Do you see how that happens? It's like, that supersedes shit. The love of your children, the love of your wife, hard work, you know, soil. I'm serious. This shit actually can help us not kill ourselves. And so when, and that, because that Muslim doesn't hate himself for being Muslim. That Muslim's like, Muhammad is a great man. You're an asshole for that. But, you know, my tribe was your tribe. So Jews are like that too with me. I take so many shots at Jews, and some like proud Jews are like, take it easy, buddy. But, you know, you're funny. It's the self-hating ones, because self-hatred, what it does is it wants to kill everybody else. It wants everyone else to feel how much hate they have in themselves. John Lennon, all these people. Every writer for The Guardian and The New York Times and Sarah Jiang and all these people, they're like, I want, like, I'm bad, so humans are bad. We got to lower the population of the world. We're cancer. We're a virus. We're causing global warming. At most, there's been 1/3 of 1 degree. Listen, you want to talk environmental problems? Bees. We're getting bees, even though I don't even know how the fuck to make honey. But you want to really help the world? Bees. That's a problem. Global warming is the toxic output of self-hatred. It's people that have that hate themselves for a variety of reasons, whether they've committed horrible acts or the pounding of these psyops, Holocaust, slavery, why are you alive? Why are you alive? And so they go, we are a disease. You know, same with the royal family. Their life is terrible. People think money's gonna get them anything. These people have to breed with first cousins, same with the Rothschilds and all these people. Satan's hollow, dude. That's why they want more people to feel it, because empty people buy shit they don't need. They're not connected to their community, and they're easy to be made into cattle. And that's why all these Jews in the media are a problem, because they look at people like me, who's, you know, proud of his work, loves his family, clear conscience, even though he's flawed, you know, and they fucking hate me for it. And they look at me and they go, I'm worried about you. You're bad. It's like, want to be specific? So that brings me to Sam Tripoli. Misery loves company. It's a cliche because it's true, right? Sam Tripoli, I want to like. I really do. He's a buffoon. He's funny to talk to because he sounds like, he's like, hey, man, my name's Sam Tripoli. What's up, dude? You're from Cortland. I'm from Cortland, New York, dude. You're from Oswego. That's cool, man. Yo, let's do comedy shows, right? But it's funny how when the party ends, people without any morality or anything good in their life and who are basically just filthy, they start falling apart. And I've watched wizards age, and I've watched selfish people age, and it's so bad. And when you see it as clear as day. They might as well be a skeleton. And when you don't, you just want to huddle up, you know. And the reason that these people won't have me on, I'll get to Joe Rogan, I'll get to Bert Kreischer. Sam Tripoli condemned me 6 months ago for the song "That Nigger Stole My Bike." And he was like, hey man, you know, I used to know Owen, but like, that's one line you can't cross. So anyway, the government's hiding aliens. It's like, would you like to debate me on censorship? Why is the N-word nigger and not necrophilia? What's it like being the victim of necrophilia? Like, let's say your mom dies and the person that you pay money to put her in the ground, he fucks her. He fucks her mouth and her pussy and just fucks your mother. Isn't that a little worse than the remnants of slavery? Why is an N-word necrophilia? Imagine if you're a victim of necrophilia, right? I can argue these points all day long. That's why they concern troll me, because it works on dumb women, like beyond. They're like, I heard Sam. It didn't even sound bad. He's like worried about you. I'm like, why do people get to vote? And I'll talk about that too, about do I actually think women shouldn't be allowed to vote? I'll explain all of it. I'll hit the big questions people ask about me. It's a way to demean someone without having the balls to even take a shot, because they can't win one goddamn argument. What would you like to talk about, Sam? Socialism? You leftist pussy? You don't trust the government, but you want to give all your money to the government and have universal health care? Okay. What else you want to debate? I'm going to ask you, what do you think about abortion? This is the whole reason why Joe Rogan probably never had me on again, is because when he brought that crackhead on, who just was like, I love abortion, I'll kill babies all day. And I'm like, really? Like, I just was reacting like, this is crazy. And 1 ounce of truth in a room full of that crazy, like, demonic shit, it's terrifying to liars. So Sam Tripoli can't ever face me. That's why they always go, we should talk on the phone. Have you thought about calling him? I used to fall for that trick. I fell for it with Joe Rogan because I didn't understand liars to that level yet. I understand wizardry, but like, I couldn't imagine a man talking to another man on the phone and saying a bunch of stuff and not meaning anything or doing any of it. Like, I really thought we like made amends in certain ways and there was a big misunderstanding and all shit. And he was just saying anything he could to get me to like him and to stop making fun of him. So the private call isn't happening with any of these people. I will do Rogan. I'll do Bert Kreischer. I'll do any of these podcasts. I'm dying to. People will be like, well, you won't even debate Jordan Peterson. I would do it all. I could be right in the middle of making love to my beautiful wife and I would stop and the jizz would hurt my balls. And she would be like, baby, you know, I need more of that sweet body. And I'd be like, you stop it. You wait for it. You sit there. I have to debate Jordan Peterson in front of people and just fucking humiliate him. They won't debate me. Sam, or fucking, you think Ben Shapiro would debate me? I would just say, why do you think Israel should get a wall and not America? Promo code Shapiro, promo code Shapiro. I'd look into the eyes of Joe Rogan, Sam Tripoli, Bert Kreischer, and say, do you guys believe in abortion? If so, why? Because the truth is a motherfucker. I could have debated that with Dave Smith till the sun came up because he's not a liar. And he was pro-choice as fuck. He's like, right up until birth. It's non-aggression principle. Then he saw the heartbeat of his unborn daughter, and now he's given his life to Jesus Christ. I mean, he jokes about that, but there's literally a little element to it. I know he can feel it. He can feel the love. He's become just he's such a good guy, Dave Smith. But like, I would look in their eyes and say, when does life begin? And why do you think a woman has the right to kill a baby? And they would say, oh, it's a woman's choice, man. What would you hate women? I go, no. What about the unborn woman? What about the unborn girl? You're killing. Men have to protect the vulnerable. That's our job. It's not to go rape the world and enslave children like Khal Drogo, Aquaman. It's saying that unborn baby is the most vulnerable person on this planet. That's why pedophiles like Jimmy Savile would rape kids close to death, children with cancer. Vulnerability, guys. That's why pedophiles go after kids from broken homes or absentee parents or, you know, just kids that are odd and don't have a lot of friends. Because it's about vulnerability. Predators go after the vulnerable. What is more vulnerable than a little baby in the womb of a woman? And here's the thing. There's been women that have argued pro-choice to me who have been the victims of rape, and I respect their opinion. I disagree completely, but they say, I don't care. I will not carry the baby of my rapist. I disagree with that, but I'm like, you have an argument. That's an argument. That means that you've at least fucking thought about it. These men haven't even thought about it, guys. They want to just keep drugging and fucking and snorting and just having people worship them. I'd look in their eyes and say, why do you think abortion's okay? Why? Is it when the heart starts beating? When they feel pain? When they can survive outside a womb? When is the moment that you feel a woman can kill her own baby? Do you know how many women have had abortions and have to live with that emotionally for the rest of their lives? I feel for those women. That's why I'm not one of those guys that's like, murderer! I'm like, fuck. I'm sorry you didn't have anyone to talk to about this and you live in a culture that tricked you into thinking that's empowering. Women are vulnerable as fuck when they're single and people don't really love them a lot and they're trying to make their way in a world that tells them empowerment is working for another man, not being married and aborting kids and being fat is fine. You can't shame them. It's like they're in a horrible situation. And then you'll have people, another group of weirdos that are like, well, I mean, but you're not willing to support welfare and these poor people, how are they supposed? I'm like, I was born poor. My parents' combined income was $12,000. Should I have been aborted? And in the year 1900, the average American lived on $1 a day in today's money. Should they have all been aborted? Have you even thought about that argument? Have you even thought about how the value of an unborn baby has to do with how much money the parents have? Are you fucking insane? And I would say this on a podcast to these people. And they would say, but we're worried about you. And I'd be like, you let them kill millions of babies. I'm not saying to go into a place and do anything, but you can't even verbally back a baby? And you're worried about me? And you think you're a man? Admit Joe Rogan's 5'6". Admit Bert Kreischer is almost certainly a bisexual. You have two options. You can either lie and stay in Hollywood or tell the truth and get kicked out. Joe Rogan is a munchkin man. Abortion's wrong. Bert Kreischer loves cocks. And you're worried about me, Sam? You're pathetic. You're on a podcast about conspiracy theories and you're pro big government. You think questioning the moon landing is stupid or something and that I can't say nigger? And then you're worried about me. Sam Tripoli ran a show called, what was it called? Sex and comedy or some shit, porn comedy. And he'd have porn stars do stand-up because they need that much attention. Because most, if not all, female porn stars, a lot of male porn stars too, were abused as children, so they have a hole inside them where they constantly need validation and they want to relive their trauma. That'll help you stop jerking off to it. Understand that they're reliving trauma, right? So Sam puts him on stage, charges money for people to come watch the women that they've jerked off to fail at comedy. He's exploiting the exploited. And he's worried about me because I'm a little off the grid in the country raising a family. Sam, you profit on raped women. You're proud of it. You're proud of that. Don't worry about me. You and your buddy, Joe Rogan. Joe Rogan is proud of getting children to do hallucinogenic drugs because it opens their mind, man. Open to what? Vox Day had a great point on one of his things. He's like, open your mind to what? Yuri, which I'm about to play you a clip about why these people are fucking dangerous, the Russian subverters. This is why you can't just hate Jews. Russia did a fucking hell of a job taking down. I know the communism, Bolshevism, a lot of them were Jews. I get it. Yuri's not a Jew. And he was on missions to get people to do yoga and smoke weed and question everything. Literally, that culture is what you do to set up a toppling. Open your mind to what? Open your mind to being okay with killing babies, to not having a border wall in your own goddamn country, to thinking women would be happier not cooking for their families, working in a cubicle and just dying? Is that what you're opening your mind to? Do you know what happens to children when they do drugs too quick, Joe Rogan? Even weed, it can bring out bipolar. Boom, one of my buddies, we started smoking weed young. I smoked weed when I was in eighth grade. One of my buddies, Gino Knopp, great guy. Good dad, he made it out of all this shit, right? We got into weed, and he had this little thing in his head that he was still too young, and he started waving around a gun, and the cops had to come, and his chick left him, and he started like buying and selling cars, and it's a mess. Drugs too young. To say like, hey, 14-year-old, open your mind to drugs. Listen, if you're 30 and you're in a fucking the woods and you want to take some mushrooms and do your thing, I'm not going to tell you how to live. I drink White Claw every night. It lands the plane. I'm not a hypocrite. Alcohol is a poison. It's a drug, but I'm fully aware of it. I would never recommend a 14-year-old. I wouldn't recommend an 18-year-old. It's for hardworking dads, dudes who work all day and they just want to fucking chill out a little and not go on like weird pills and shit. And it's social and you just land the plane. It's all it is. And it's probably better for me not to, but it also makes me, I don't know. Like when I drink, I get like kind of loving. You know, I never black out. I never want a ton. I don't drink liquor. Like Amy, she spent all day. She's just flowering. It's amazing. She's glowing. She spent all day researching like new like food ideas and this one tequila drink that she really wanted to try with like all these fresh ingredients and local honey and she's taking all this pride and time and she's like, do you want some of this? I'm like, if I drink tequila, I may just get hammered. I don't have a gauge. I'm a beer guy, so I like no sugar. Boom. All right. So anyway, why are people like Sam Tripoli, Joe Rogan, these people dangerous? Because they're pushing a culture that emasculates the men so they just drop like flies. Ben Shapiro does the same shit. It's just right wing, so you don't really catch it as much. He's lined up right with abortion, but he's trying to send people to fight wars that he won't fight in for Israel security. You think Syria is a big threat to America? No. I wouldn't have even realized how fucked up our relationship is with Israel until this wall debacle. We can't get our own wall. Imagine if you're dad and you're like, hey dad, can I get some new shoes? It's like, sorry buddy, your second cousin, who we do see once a year and we're real glad he's happy, I had to buy him 5 tuxedos. So you're gonna have to wait on the shoes, maybe start a GoFundMe. You know, I'm not saying that the second cousin shouldn't exist, but like, what the fuck is going on with that shit? Are you guys having fun? 5,700 people? Holy shit. How does Rogan emasculate men? Are you fucking kidding me? He's pro-choice, which means, hey guys, when you have sex with a woman, don't take the sex seriously or any commitment. And if she gets pregnant, kill it. He's all about psychedelics. Take mushrooms, DMT, get all fucked up. Dude, just keep searching for shit. You know, just go out there and like freeze your body and just, you know, go on a fucking 3-month hunting trip. Fuck your daughters and your wife and shit. Just bail, you know? Him and other men will talk openly about how they want to fuck other women and like how hot threesomes are and shit. I've had some sex in my life, guys. If I could point to an old sin or an old screw tape letters type weakness where the devil could have got me, lust, right? And I never had sex with a porn star, any of these people. It's never the vulnerable. It was just alpha shit. Straight up. I was in my 20s. Women would be like, I want you. And I'd be like, no, no way. That's fucking awesome. He's a married man with kids and his role modeling. Have you ever once heard me talk about how a woman's hot or how a threesome's great or like, wow, it's great how much pussy you get? That would be humiliating for my wife and children. Yeah. Do you understand how emasculating that is to disrespect your own wife? Like to disrespect monogamy? To say that marriage is just a piece of paper and shit and stupid. Yeah, the courts are fucked. The courts are terrible, right? They destroy men's lives. You know, you marry some awful chick. She takes your kids, makes you pay. Well, she's fucking some black guy she met at the beach. That's not marriage. That's the courts. People not identifying the snakes and just marriage is beautiful. Commit your soul to one woman. And be proud of that. Don't be proud of your drug habit. Don't be proud of selling like devices to make guys fucking jack off better in their mom's basement. Joe Rogan's rich. These people that listen to him are not rich. That's the thing that bothered me so much about Jordan Peterson. I know people would pay $300 to fucking see me talk. I also know a lot of them do it because they want to be good people and they want to support me and strong men and doing the right thing and they're saving up for their house. That's why my tickets are $20. I got to make a living, but I will not exploit you. And when I saw Jordan Peterson, I know his audience. We have some crossover audience. It's young men that are like, thank you for being strong in the face of emasculating men and fucking BuzzFeed and Salon and having to say him, her, zero. And so what does he do? He says, oh yeah, you want to be a strong man, huh? Give me $300 to see me once. Fuck that. I get crazy support from you guys. You're generous. Yeah, but it's always your decision. You don't have to pay to watch me talk. You never have to pay fucking $300 to see me speak. You got your mind? And people would do that. I inspire people. I know that wizard shit. This is the thing that really straightened me out with women. Because when I first met Amy, I'll tell you guys a story. And this is a perfect example of the difference between truth and being a strong man and being a false alpha. It sounds like funny and it would be a brag if I was hanging out with just degenerated psychopaths like Sam Tripoli. But here's a perfect story. I was thinking about this today as I finished my fence, and then I'll play you the Yuri clip. And I got a couple more clips. Like, how do I describe what Hitler is? Like, why is Hitler, Khal Drogo, like the difference between power and force and authority and truth? You know, control isn't bad. Control over others is bad. Control over your property, you know, your rituals, your traditions. Great. This isn't evil, what I did at all, but it was out of insecurity. So I just didn't know it yet because I hadn't been in love with a woman before. I thought I had been, but I hadn't. So I was on stage one night in Hollywood. I was probably 25 and I was crushing. And this one girl, I don't remember what she looked like, but I remember she was a cute girl. And she was just staring at me and smiling. And her boyfriend was getting pissed. And he just kept being like, he started heckling me. And here's the thing about men that understand women and sex and all that stuff. There's a reason why a lot of you dudes are strong, powerful, non-cuck, great men. And you're like, yo, I can't wait to introduce you to my wife because you know I'm not a threat because I have no interest in that shit. None. And you know it. And you know your wife isn't going to want me because she's happy with you. These are things that a lot of these gamma men have no idea. I'm about to say something and people are going to be like, must be nice. Those are the guys you got to watch out for because they'll fuck anytime they have an opportunity, they'll go for it because they don't understand what sex is and what women are and what it all is. So when a lot of women want to have sex with you, and that happens for a variety of reasons, they like people with courage, they like people with social status, and they like people that can make them laugh and play the piano. And that's just true. Now, I could take my wife to see Michael Bublé, and she doesn't want to fuck him because she feels safe and happy. That's what people have to understand. Women are not whores. They're like, when they're vulnerable or when they're unsatisfied or when their husband is a fucking loser, that's when they're like, act whorish. But like, I don't feel at all threatened by other men because my wife's happy. And if she was single and if she wasn't with me, she'd probably want to fuck Michael Bublé because he has all the qualities that she's attracted to. I don't know. I don't even know what he looks like. But anyway, so I'm on stage and the guy starts heckling me. Money is not as much of an aphrodisiac as people think. I swear to God, and I'm being honest with you guys, because some of these tough realities people just don't believe for some reason. Like, remember that rap lyric where it's like, he's working at McDonald's, but look at his eyes. He's like, right now it's the floors, next week it's the fries. Some of the most committed women to men I know who would just ride or die for life, they worship their men. The dudes are like plumbers, truck drivers, fucking arborists like my brother. My sister-in-law is obsessed with my brother. And then I know like bankers that their women are constantly fucking strangers. Money isn't what people think. It's a deception. Courage, that's why I just listed the shit. Status, you know, money can give you status. But it's not money. It's courage, safety, make them laugh, make them feel, you know, open up a little, be honest. And this is one reason why Sam Tripoli and his elk think that they know me and shit. They're like, yo, we know you, Owen. This isn't the real Owen. And I was going through my head, like, have I been evil? Like, what are my vices? Like, what have they seen me do that makes them think that I'm one of them? I was very offended. I'm like, it must have been women. And then I'd be with a woman and then she'd come back like a week later and like check out a show and just be like, hi. And it used to blow guys' minds. They'd be like, how the fuck do you do that? And I'm like, don't lie to them. Don't fuck vulnerable women. And then they don't hate you for it. Women aren't designed to hate men. I've never told a woman I loved her unless I thought I did. I've loved one woman. She's inside. I thought I loved other women. I've never been like, I love you, baby. Come on. Never. That's what makes women hate you. And there's women right now in the chat. I'm about to talk about some pretty fucking, not depraved. It's pretty hilarious. But like, women aren't going to be mad at me for this because I'm telling God's honest truth. Women get angry at men when you lie to them, right? And so this is the thing that happened with Amy. When we first started dating, I was still like, listen, baby, I'm a legend. I'm a man. You don't know what it's like to be a man. I got jizz in these balls. Legend. You know, you're a woman. I'm going to try to, you know, do the straight and narrow, but legend. That's so cowardly, guy. Looking back, it's embarrassing as fuck. We broke up. She loved me so much and wanted me in her life so much. She said to me, I can accept this about you, but I hate it. And that broke so many paradigms in my mind and propaganda and all this shit about how, like, if you give your heart to a woman, she'll manipulate you and they just want to control you. I'm like, and even right now, some dudes are probably like, that's a trick. It's not. You got to understand, Amy's like me. She has this like autistic honesty almost too, where it's like, she said that. I'm like, I can fuck other women and she'll stay with me and it'll cause her pain. And I saw vulnerability and I'm like, no, this is not a good path. This is not a good path. And I thought that I was cursed for life. I thought that I would always be tempted by women. I always loved sex, loved the beauty of women, the smell of women, everything about the attention, all of it. Looking back, it's a joke. It's like I used to chew tobacco all the time. The smell of chew would make me vomit. The thought of being with another woman is insane. Because it's like real alpha shit is build a family. Well, you just want to cowardly fuck people in a little apartment. Just text a little bit. See if you can get your dick sucked. What are you, a fucking child? Like, that's insanely dumb. There's no better sex. And another thing is people will sell you this lie that like one night stand lustful sex is better sex. It's like, oh, me and my wife, we don't really. Yeah, we'll go stretches. We don't have sex because of child rearing and shit like that. But like loving sex when you know the person's body and you respect them and you're attracted to them, you fuck and make love at the same time. It's mind blowing. Then add on the fact that you see that fucking makes children. And now you finally respect your own dick. You're like, that's why you're so all about it. These cowards in Hollywood are like, when you get a girl pregnant, murder it. So you can keep fucking, keep coming. No, being a man is being with a woman when she feels disgusting and can't shower. She's covered in shit and piss and fucking vomit. And she's like, you still love me, baby? Like, of course, I'll die for you. That's being alpha. So this is the story. So I'm on stage. And this guy wouldn't shut the fuck up. And so I, in my classic Owenisms, I say something deadly true that the crowd finds hilarious. I go, if you don't shut up, I'll have sex with your girlfriend. And I mean that. Just like how I am with Bannings, that's how I was with this guy. And I'm like, buddy, I don't want to do it. You're on a date. This is embarrassing. But like, if you keep heckling me, I will fuck your girlfriend. Because she was looking at me. Like, you can feel it. Like, that's why I can be friends with certain women. It's like, Delev does not want to fuck me. She would find naked me, like, embarrassing and gross. Like, people that understand sex are actually some of the best people to be around women. Because you feel it. Like, some of these gamma shitty men, these, like, just leftist shitty men, they're like, anytime they can spot vulnerability, they're in. The true nature of sex, and my sexual habit came from women wanting to have sex with me. And so I knew the feeling. I was like, this chick wants to fuck me. And it's like, I don't want to do that to you. But like, if you keep doing it, dude, and he wouldn't stop. And I didn't like pursue it. I thought I was just being funny, but the way jokes work is they just become true. And so I just kind of did my own thing. And I'd recently gotten Facebook. It was that long ago. I just see a message. You were really funny tonight. It was a girl. I just gave her my address. Just came over, just immediately started kissing me. Just taking my clothes off. I held in the laughter. The guy heckled me, so I fucked his girlfriend. That's not alpha. It's funny. I didn't have a family, so it's not like evil or anything. But it's bad. I didn't have sex till college, right? And I was still blown away that women wanted me. And I used it almost as like a way to show myself that I was alpha or good or a man or something. And it's Groundhog's Day, you know? It's like you keep getting with other women because you just can't get past that hump because you're a coward and you just want to soothe your ego. It's one thing when you're young and you're figuring out, you know, what sex is and what dating is and what... I'm a sexual conservative now. I'm going to raise Walter to be like, sex is about love. My parents had only been with each other, and they're also academics. So it's the horrifying combination of being crazy open-minded to everything and not understanding dating at all. They've only fucked each other. So I didn't really get it. I didn't get like the how much you lose, you know? And so when you have these quote-unquote men encouraging other men and having on like his buddies to talk about being open and orgies and love and all this, that isn't being a man. You're hurting your woman when you do that. If you're powerful enough and you have enough swagger, you know, I'm talented enough where women would potentially be like, I'll accept that if you need sex. That would hurt them. And if it doesn't hurt them, they don't love you. And so if you intentionally hurt women because you want to get off with your ego, even though if you think another woman's hotter than your woman, and you're staying with someone else, then you're already a loser. So the sex can't be better. You know, if you don't think your woman is crazy hot and everybody else is shit, no offense, ladies, it's like, what's the point of that? To pleasure your own cock? Joe Rogan's 52. What the fuck is he doing? And it's like, I don't mind attacking him. I'm trying to describe why I have issues with these people. And then personal issues. It's one thing if you're just immoral. Everybody battles sin. Everybody battles immorality. We're all broken. We're all sinners. That judgy Christian shit is one of the reasons I wasn't Christian for 25 years. That whole like, oh my God, you once looked at porn? I never have. My only sin is to give to the church too much. Meanwhile, they're like raping kids. But if you're going to come at me and try and give me advice like Joe Rogan did on his own podcast like two or three times, and the reason I apologized, I thought he genuinely, me and him had a mix up and that he was going to have me back on and we were going to have an actual conversation. He never did. He never had Alex on. And he's been shilling and cucking ever since. But I'm not, I don't feel bad that I believed him. I believe people until they lie, you know? And that's why I was like, oh, I never asked Joe to go back on his show. And if people were like, yo, dude, you're just trying to get on Joe Rogan's show. Nigger, I got 6,000 people watching me right now. Joe has what, 20, 25,000 live? He's funded by like everybody, all this deep state shit. He doesn't pay me. I would pay my own way. I did it because I thought he was interesting. I get nothing from his show. I don't even like how many people know me. Like, this is pretty maxed out with how big I want this stream to get. You know, it's like, I don't want the golden prison of fame. I like respect though. Like in Best Buy, some like, you know, I'll be out and somebody will be like, yo man, you're Owen Benjamin? I'm like, yeah. They're like, dude, you helped me get through some shit, dude. Thanks for standing up. I'm like, oh, cool. And that's it. They don't even want to be like, yo, can I smell your hair? It's beautiful. So it's like what he has, I don't even fucking want. I just wanted to go back in after the last time he humiliated me by bringing on a crackhead and screaming at me about how I should run tweets by him. I'd run tweets by a 4-foot fucking monkey who thinks it's okay to talk about other women and drugs and fucking, he mocks my Lord. He thinks Christianity's retarded and Jesus is like a retard and shit. Listen, I get it, man. If you want to go truth, you want to talk about Jesus Christ being like a faggot and stuff, go right ahead, dude. I can be friends with somebody who does that, but you better let me talk after. You better let me talk about how you're, what you believe is, and these fucking cowards never will. Sam Tripoli concern trolled me, talking about how he's worried about me. He won't have me on because I would annihilate him. My ethics, because I question the moon landing, or that I call Joe Rogan short. He is short. He's so short, it's uncomfortable. Like, do I pat his head? It's like, I'm spitting some truths, man, some vulnerable shit. I don't like that I just told that story about fucking that heckler's girl. It's funny, but like, I have shame in that. It's not good, that shows my weakness, not my strength. How many women, like fucking models and threesomes? Dude, this one very famous guy, and I don't slander. Ask Coddington or Delever, anybody that really know my stories. Like, I am being merciful about my shit, other people's shit. I'm not. Dude, if you knew the actor who was telling me about how he stacks women's asses when he fucks them and how politically active he is, how he's huge. He's a Marvel character. And we're talking one night, we're hanging. There's a lot of these retards are attracted to comedy because they're so insecure, because actors, a lot of them don't know who they are. Oh my God, you're so strong up there. He's talking about how a traditional stack versus a non-traditional stack is how you stack women's asses and how many models he would stack. And I'm like, dude, you're so short and so sad. And that was even back before Amy. It's like, the thought of thinking that makes you a man and not building fences and spitting hard truths and protecting your kids and giving your kids innocence and allowing your wife to eat all the food she wants and like to really be a mom, stacking asses. And this same fucking nigger, white guy, by the way, so don't think, I didn't say who he was. So I don't call black people nigger. I just won't say N-word. Unless one steals my bike or something. But this dude, on Twitter and politically, he's the biggest leftist, moral, fucking Trump is Hitler He stacks asses. Those women probably have issues with their dad, or they're wicked lonely or real confused in a world where they're supposed to be, you know, super mom and work harder than all the men and abort and like not take shit. Women are in a position a lot like Jews, because Jews didn't have a homeland. And people knew how much they wanted it. And women want security. And so you take a group of people that bought, you know, just alone, just kind of Jews are like, yeah, you know, I'm just kind of here. Like, I don't have a homeland, and people kind of think I'm weird for my fucking weird hair. And then you do the Saul Alinsky shit where it's like, you know, the Holocaust, everyone was killed, and the Germans and fucking, and then they get so fucked up in the head, they become evil. It's women. I see the same shit happen with women. Women are so vulnerable. Imagine, I don't know if you're a dude, you've ever walked into a gay bar, and the way people look at you is with a very specific look. They want to be inside of you. And it's very disturbing. I've had very close gay friends, and the reason it's possible is if they don't want to be inside of me. There's a look that people give you where they're like, and you just are like, holy fuck, this guy wants to be inside of me. And then you look somewhere else, and it's like, he wants to be inside of me. And then you realize you're doing resting bitch face. This all happens at a gay bar to a dude. And then you start being a little like, someone, can I just get someone to not let this happen? That's all women all the time. Everywhere they go, people are like, they want to put something inside of you. You know, and there's so many shitty men. That's why it's so funny. Like, actual alpha males are like, you know, I'm not fully aware of all the categories or whatever, like Delta or whatever. Like, Vox Data is a great job explaining it, but like, we're not trying to be inside of you. Actual alpha males protect nation, family, God, work, sacrifice. And they, you know, there's usually alpha males went through a phase in their life when they completely understand what sex is, what makes it pleasurable, what makes someone aroused by you, what it is. And that way they know how to be around people. And it's actually very relaxing. That's why a lot of alphas trust each other. I don't know if alpha is the right word, because there are like sex addict alphas. Just like honorable men that can get sex are the ones I trust. You know, that I'm like, oh, that person's not going to like rape my friend when she passes out. He gets it. Sam Tripoli looks to me like a rapist eyes. Like, he's like, I just want to fuck and be inside somebody. Sneak, like, let's just have 20 beers and hang out. All right. I'll play you guys some more stuff. You guys having a good time? 6,000 people, yeah. As such a man, I agree 100% truth. It's a fact. Being a great, devoted husband and father is the opposite of a cuck. But just like subversion, they take a man, a husband, a father, and they put him in all these roles on television and they make him pathetic. You know, like, even dad can do it. It's like, oh, I'm just here. That's the alpha. Not Khal Drago talking about raping the world and having women masturbate to it. Christian Grey, you know how many women masturbate to that book? That's their porn. That guy is a fucking psychopath. That guy has no, but it taps into their shit, because that guy would make them feel safe. Resources and fucking the will. And the, like, women have this weird thing in the romance novels where they want someone who's violent and vile and fucks and murders, but suddenly only has eyes for one woman. Doesn't happen. Monogamy starts with morality, and then your body understands it. But at first, it's not, because you're like, you're just this vile beast, fucking billionaire, you know, S&M guy, and then you meet the girl. No, it comes from morality. It comes from not wanting to take advantage of people. And so women are literally masturbating to this book. It's outsold the fucking Bible, dude. And so that clues you in into what women want and what hijacks women. They don't want that guy. So many women in this chat will tell you this, and men that have been burned in the past won't believe it. They'll be like, oh, you're just saying that. You want to fuck that guy. They don't. If a woman feels safe, if a woman feels protected, if a woman feels loved, honored, and respected, they don't want to fuck Christian Grey. They don't want him to hang out at your fires. Trust me, I have buddies that have murdered a lot of people or killed a lot of people in war, depending on which way you look at it. Handsome, athletic, chisel. You know, my wife gets freaked out by those guys. She's like, he's an outdoor friend. Like, what do you mean he's an outdoor friend? I'm telling you, like people that are decisive warrior Khal Drogo types, Amy's not into that. She doesn't even want him around, but she respects that I hang out with those guys a lot. So it's like, that's an outdoor friend because they're unstable and she values her life. So women don't actually want that. Scared, vulnerable women do. Post-World War I, Versailles, Germany wanted Hitler. You know, like, fucking Delaware doesn't want Hitler. You understand? When you got wheelbarrows of money buying bread, people starving in the streets, you know, half the country fucking died. Everyone's got like a no arm. They have like this deep emotional wound from World War I, this pointless war that they have all the blame for. It's like they want Khal Drogo. I get it. Still evil. And that's how you, because I confuse Nazis so hard because I call out Jews hard. But then I also am not a fan of Mean Mr. Mustache. And I also respect the existence of Israel. And Nazis get so confused because they like me. And I respect Nazis more than I like socialists. I'll tell you that. Self-hate terrifies me. Nazis are, they've committed to the power evil shit because they don't want to be hurt anymore. They want to kill all the snakes, burn everything down. It's teetering on nihilism and most certainly satanistic. But like leftism is empty self-hate. Like leftism, like a Nazi isn't going to finger a sleeping girl. But he may kill millions of innocent people because he didn't think through it. He's acting out of rage. That's, you know, that's what evil is. And so I'm trying to really help people get to that point because I get it, dude. I've felt self-hate in my life. I've felt blind rage. And it's like I want to help talk out these issues because the media isn't doing it. A lot of people don't have family members. You know, this is valuable. Because I'm not special. I'm lucky. I got to meet people in my life and see shit that most people will never be able to see. Most people can never definitively say being a rich movie star is hell. I can't. And people can, and people will believe it because they know I know. They know I gave up shit because, and I'm enough of just a normal guy where I'm not this like martyr. I'm not like, I must die for Jesus Christ. I'm like, that's a bad road. And so I feel this like intense desire to pass this knowledge on to people because it can really help people, like good people going down the wrong path all the time. Like there's good women that have had abortions. There's good men that believe socialism is our answer. There's good men that, you know, worship Joe Rogan and think that's exactly what a man should be. I'm just trying to help them understand that there's another option. And always, always be very careful with people that don't want you to look at or see things. I don't watch Rogan because it feels like noise and like just jarring. It's like, but like, imagine if I was like, don't even watch him. Don't plug your ears. Don't even look at him. No, watch Jordan Peterson. Watch Joe Rogan. Once you're awakened to the wizardry, I want people to see it for themselves. It's like, look at it. Look at what he just said. He just said that bitch from Girls, that show Girls, the fact she said she wished she had had an abortion, that he respects that. It's one thing if you're under a spell, it's like alpha, masculine. You know, this is where men are vulnerable. Women are vulnerable all the time because everyone wants to put something inside of them. Men are vulnerable when we see an alpha role model. We will overlook a lot of shit. I've done that a lot. When people call me like, you know, that I turn on people and I get pissed at shit. No, I call out evil. My instincts are not that at all. My instincts are like, oh no, he means well. He just likes to collect human heads. I mean, that's what he. I'm so tribal. It's fucking laughable. When I see a strong male role model, I have such instincts to like overlook so much shit. And it's like I know a lot of men get hijacked by that. They see one honest thing someone did. That's why I tell people, don't make a hero out of me. Don't make an icon out of me. I'll only disappoint you, and it'll be bad for your own soul. I'm a positive male role model, which is what we need. I'm an elder at 38 because people keep locking away the old people. Old people know shit. Listen to old people. And it's like young kids are being robbed of their fucking, of their identity, of their history, of a way to logically think through things. I want Sam Tripoli to watch this whole fucking podcast and write me an essay responding to all my points, right? I got more videos and shit for you too, by the way. I just want to get the fire going again. And men are dying for it. Women are dying to feel safe. And that's a bad position. That brings in caliphates and shit. Men are dying for a strong male role model. That's why I'm worried about the Hitler characters now. Because when you're in a world like this, when it's like toxic masculinity, can you use a Gillette razor and be a better man? There's more online bullying with women. I'm not even addressing Gillette because part of their whole fucking scam is the outrage backlash. That's how they're passing this message. I figured it out. I'm dying to fucking mock it, but like, I know what they're doing. They're destroying the male psyche where it's like, who's strong? And then you find a racist who believes it. You know, a hateful guy who believes it. A guy who's embraced power. You know, and you'll see in his eyes that he's not lying. And he's like, we got to kill all the Jews. And then we'll kill all the Catholics, then the Jesuits, then the Chinamen. That guy believes it because he's went the wrong direction. If there's self-hate and then there's out. That's actually what outrage is. Outrage, right? It's like if I scrub the world clean, no one will hurt me. Sounds leftist eugenics again, doesn't it? Right? The Slavs don't deserve to live. Ukraine doesn't deserve to live. We are the Germans. We get to populate these places. Want to tell that to Goebbels? He's 4'11" with a gimp. Well, no, Goebbels is cool. No, Goebbels is a good guy. He's 4'11" with a gimp. What are the policies? What doesn't it sound like YouTube, Twitter, all this shit? What are the rules and policies, Hitler? So you're Austrian and have black hair and you're 5'7". Owen, I'm a quarter ethnically Jewish, which makes no sense to me, by the way. It's one of the reasons I think it's very lizard shit. Owen legally would have, in different eras, I get it. Some Nazis have corrected me and been like, no, the law is about quarter Jew gets you killed in a lot of Nazi era. I'm pushing 6'8", blue-eyed, athletic, 147 IQ, right? I'm way more master race than Adolf Hitler or Goebbels. So is a black legend that looks like that and is smart like that. They would have killed me and kept Goebbels. Does that sound like Twitter to you? It does me. Rules and guidelines and shit, they change every day. It's like, oh no, Goebbels is a good guy. He's 4'11" with a gimp. Like, that hypocrisy is when, because you can't take down a Nazi ideology. Like, if someone loves Hitler because he stood up against the Weimar Republic, which was a heroic act, the Jew stuff won't work because of all the propaganda. Talk about Goebbels, the Slavs. Why would you kill Ukraine? The fuck did Ukraine do to you? Oh, they're not German. Well, then what the fuck is Goebbels? He's 4'11 with a gimp. See, that's the thing I try to do. It's about logical consistency. You know, because people can be wrong as fuck, myself included. But if you don't even give a fuck that it makes sense or not, you are sucking the devil's dick, man. And everybody knows it. Like, Sam Tripoli doesn't trust the government, but is a socialist. So you know he's full-blown retard already, right? Like, that means that things in his head don't have to make sense. And so I'm going to get this fire going and play this Yuri shit. But just my advice to Jews, don't hate Hitler too much or else you start having weird responses to it. Understand that Hitler, Stalin, Pol Pot, Mao Zedong, fucking Obama, you know, there's Hillary Clinton. Hillary Clinton is so similar to Adolf Hitler when it comes to bloodlust, power, lack of morality. If you isolate it to one dude, you're not seeing the fucking enemies either. I recommend that with Islam as well for the Jews. It's like Iran 1975. And I'm about to play the Shah's fucking video. You'd meet a bunch of people then you wouldn't even know they were Muslim. Cut to Hamas, cut to ISIS. They're like, all we care about is being Muslim. We're going to fucking kill everybody. Desperate times lead to desperate people. Islam has a horrible Achilles heel to it. It's a governmental structure and it's about submission. Muhammad was a warlord. Jesus Christ was a carpenter and a lover. And he said, like, he was a builder. And he said, you know, Caesar does Caesar. We do us. We're truth, their power. That's inherently better. Inherently. That being said, there's a lot of people that are like, I guess I'm a Muslim. Well, not anymore. Now they're so fucking jacked up. That's what happens when you take out their leaders. You know? And at that point, it's like spite. All right, so here's Yuri, and this is why these people are dangerous. This guy was a defector from Russia. And we get to the shot round. This is going to be a marathon one tonight. When I work on stuff like this, I get a lot of material, and then I just keep going. Just you can tap out anytime you want. Don't feel obligated. I'm just so excited because I also finished my fence today. So I don't know if you can tell. I got a real twinkle in my eye. All right, Yuri Bezmenov. Deception was my job. That's my nigga. I thought I had this queued up. Fucking Jews. The Jews are always getting me. Man. Man, come on. There we go. Here's old Yuri. Yuri Bezmus up, been off. So this is the men they want in a society, and this is why once they take control, they would kill all the leftists, by the way. All these retards waving flags at protests and Antifa, they're all dead. All of them are dead. They're useful idiots. This is why cultural subversion is so dangerous. The Joe Rogans of the world getting men to get all hippied out and question everything with no real moral backbone. I question a lot of shit, but then you focus on true and false. You don't just go, well, yesterday I thought that, but today I think this because I feel different and I just want to come and eat drugs and kick bags and no one say I'm short. Because then these guys come in and they take your women and your kids. They rape your women, they enslave your children. That's their goal. And that's ancient. It's not just the Russians, not just the Jews, not just the Chinamen. It's ancient. Yuri. Oh, and they killed this guy, by the way, in Canada. But he's an awesome dude. I don't think he even gave a fuck. He's probably tired.
That's basically most, that's all for my okay, we can slides.
We can turn off the projector, and that's very interesting. Well, you spoke several times before about ideological subversion. That is a phrase that I'm afraid some Americans don't fully understand. When the Soviets use the phrase ideological subversion, what do they mean by it?
Ideological subversion is the process which is legitimate, overt, and open. You can see it with your own eyes. All you have to do, all American mass media has to do, is to unplug their bananas from their ears, open up their eyes, and they can see it. There is no mystery. There is nothing to do with espionage. I know that espionage intelligence gathering looks more romantic. It sells more deodorants through the advertising, probably. That's why your Hollywood producers are so crazy about James Bond type of thrillers. But in reality, the main emphasis of the KGB is not in the area of intelligence at all. According to my opinion and opinion of many defectors of my caliber, only about 15% of time, money, and manpower is spent on espionage as such. The other 85% is a slow process which we call either ideological subversion or active measures, активные мероприятия in the language of the KGB, or psychological warfare. What it basically means is to change the perception of reality of every American to such an extent that despite of the abundance of information, no one is able to come to sensible conclusions in the interests of defending themselves, their families, their community, and their country. It's a great brainwashing process which goes very slow, and it's divided in four basic stages. The first one being demoralization. It takes from 15 to 20 years to demoralize a nation. Why that many years? Because this is the minimum number of years which requires to educate one generation of students in the country of your enemy, exposed to the ideology of the enemy. In other words, Marxism-Leninism ideology is being pumped into the soft heads of at least three generations of American students without being challenged or counterbalanced by the basic values of Americanism, American patriotism. The result you can see, most of the people who graduated in the 60s, dropouts or half-baked intellectuals, are now occupying the positions of power in the government, civil service, business, mass media, educational system. You are stuck with them. You cannot get rid of them. They are contaminated. They are programmed to think and react to certain stimuli in a certain pattern. You cannot change their mind, even if you expose them to authentic information, even if you prove that white is white and black is black, you still cannot change the basic perception and the logic of behavior. In other words, these people, the process of demoralization is complete and irreversible. To get rid society of these people, you need another 20 or 15 years to educate a new generation of patriotically minded and common sense people.
Let's talk about this for a second. Okay. That's why I get terrified when I see people with information that disproves their point, and they're like, no. That's why it's called Eyes Wide Shut. Where you go, you're washed, man. And it's like, those people won't get out of that. Yuri talks about it. He's like, they only get out of it when there's a boot on their neck. And it's so painful for them to get out of this propaganda that they're useless for the new regime and they're all killed. That's why Pol Pot killed everyone with glasses, any intellectual. That's one reason why just overt Jew hate doesn't quite work, because they're using the Jews. The Jews have a self-hatred about them where they're prone to openness and, like, you know, self-hatred makes you go towards like the Joe Rogans and the Jordan Petersons, where it's like, you know, let's just open our minds and indulge and blah, blah. And then they get taken and put into media positions and blah, blah. Meanwhile, they're not the puppet masters. There's probably a few of them that are, but a lot of them are just these like morally empty, nationless people that were taught over and over and over again by some really powerful dudes in other countries to hate themselves, to open up their mind to anything, to subvert all the cultures. And then once they get power, the whole place is so weak, they just knock it over with anything. Well, just listen to Yuri. This is fucking legit, dude. And that's why it's like, I encourage people to watch these things, learn it. I'm reading Mein Kampf, not because I'm a Nazi, because I want to know what the fuck Hitler's, all his arguments were. People that say, oh, don't read that. Don't read the Bible. Don't watch Yuri, bro. This is crazy. It's like, what are you scared of, nigger? What are you scared of? What are you scared of, Sam Tripoli? Why am I persona non grata? I'm not that special. I didn't used to be the funniest person. I now am literally the last comic standing. Even Norm apologized to The View. Bill Burr's like a Black Lives Matter guy. It's like, in 2005... the amount of funny people that were willing to offend and ballsy and artistic was unbelievable. I feel like the boat that survived that hurricane and fucking Forrest Gump. Remember Forrest Gump is like, he's doing all right. He's a fisherman. And then all the other boats get destroyed. That's how I feel in comedy. And it's like, all these people are like, don't watch Owen. Don't talk to Owen. It's like, what are you scared of? Yeah, now I'm like one of the funniest people, but that's only because you guys all suck the devil's dick. Are you scared I'm right? Because it's the same with anything. It's like, don't be friends with Fox Day. Don't be friends with Steven Crowder. Don't be friends with the socialists. Don't listen to what they have to say. No, don't listen to them. No, they're evil. They're bad. What are you scared of? Sam Tripoli sells women. Sam Tripoli takes women that were abused, puts them on stage, and he makes money on it. But I can't be friends with someone who has a different political agenda. That's how I feel about Dennis Prager. I respect Dennis Prager's balls. He's got great paternal advice. I don't like the fact that he says that, like, it's a moral issue that we have to give money to Israel. It's a bit of a bait and switch. I don't like rules for thee, not for me. I never liked that. And so I respect him as a man. I disagree with his politics at this point. That's so much different than like hating a person. You know, like, I think Jordan Peterson is vile. I think that he's trying to garner control and like submission and power and weird, creepy, creepy, evil shit. Dennis Prager is just kind of playing two teams. You know, I'm like, is this really for America or for Israel? People are like, oh, you're Nazi. You don't think Israel should exist. No, it should exist. I want to know why they get a wall and we don't get a wall. And if I'm not allowed to debate that with you, it means you're up to some shit. But he's tall. He's got a lot of balls. He's done some good things. He inspires people. But don't let these people trick you and to be like, yeah, America doesn't deserve protection. We're of many come one. So everyone's allowed to come in. Yeah, am I allowed in your house, Dennis? Come on. You're a good guy. You're a musician.